Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are making video on simple if in programming in C. Already we discussed about what is control structures and types of control structures in C language. Okay. Now we are extending we are learning each and every part of the control structure. Under this, the first one is simple if. I am again telling you the origin behind the story. So the first part is control structures. The control structures are divided into conditional control structures, loop control structures, unconditional control structures. Again, this conditional control structure is divided into two more categories. Under one is decision making. Or branching. Second one is selection based. Under the decision making, we have divided into four categories. One is simple if else, nested if else, and else if ladder. Okay, under selection based, it is switch case. Loop control structures are divided into two categories. One is infinite loops, and second one is finite loops. Infinite loops are classified into two things. One is while and second one is do while. For finite loop, it is for. Okay. Again, unconditional control structures. Break, continue, and go to. In the entire skeleton, we are learning simple if now. Okay, so the simple if syntax, if the condition is condition, if this condition is true, then statements 1 and statements 2 are executed. If the condition is false, then only statements 2 are executed. That is the meaning of simple if. If this is true, then the statements are executed. If it is false, the statements will not be executed. Only simple cause is mentioned here. Okay, so the flow diagram is if condition yes, statements 1, no statements, followed by statements 2. Okay, this is the way we are representing. This can be also represented in another way, that is condition yes, statements 1, no, statements 2, so on. If this is true, then statements 1 and statements 2 are executed. If this is false, directly the statement 2 will be executed. That is the meaning of simple if. Okay. Here I am also telling few things. The condition may be simple or complex. Simple means A greater than B. Complex means A greater than B and A greater than C. So let us take simple example. If it is more conditions are checked, automatically it is complex. Okay, that is nothing more. And the next one is, these are, if the number of statements are 1, option to use these brackets. If the number of statements are more than 1, mandatory to use the brackets. That is minimum symbolic information related to simple if. Now we are taking few examples. Now, the first example, write a C program to find the greatest of two numbers. While checking greatest of two numbers, we need to take two variables A and B. Now we are checking if we need to read the value of A and B. After that, if A greater than B, simply we can say that printf percentage D is greatest. So A. Similarly, we need to check second condition, B greater than A, printf percentage D is greatest B. This is very simple, we are checking the condition. Okay, and the next one is write a C program to check the given year is leap year or not. So when we say a year is leap year, every four years the leap year will be occurred, and in leap year the number of days is 366 and the non-leap year the number of days are 365. In the February month, generally 28, if it is leap year it is 29. That is the only changes are occurred. So what we are doing is we need to read the variable year. If that year mod 4 is equal to 0, then we can say that percentage D is leap year and we need to print year. If year mod 4 not equal to 0, we need to print percentage D is non-leap year year. This is the way we are printing the values. Similarly, write a C program to check the given number is even or odd. So how can you say a number is even or odd? Even means divided by 2, remainder is 0, then it is called even number. Divided by 2, remainder is not equal to 0 is called odd number. So based on this information, we need to write the program. If n mod 2 is equal to 0, then printf percentage D is even. So n. If n mod 2 not equal to 0, then printf percentage D is odd n. This is the way we are finding it. So the next one is write a C program to check the second number is factor of first number or not. Very simple this question. So the objective of this is A mod B is remainder 0, then it is true. A mod B remainder not 0, then it is false. So simple cause we are taking it. If A mod B is equal to 0, so we can say that printf percentage D is factor of percentage D B comma A. Similarly, if A mod B not equal to 0, printf percentage D is not a factor of percentage D B comma A. Simple. The solution is very very simple. You need to understand the basic definitions, automatically you can answer the programs. So the next one is write a C program to check the given number is positive number or not. Let us take n is the number. If this number is greater than equal to 0, then it is positive. Okay, if this is less than 0, then it is negative number. Okay, so based on this, if n is greater than equal to 0, we can print that percentage D is positive and n. Similarly, if n less than 0, printf percentage D is negative n. So this is the way we are computing very easily in SimpleIF. Thank you.